Gospel that you're really underselling it. Three touchdowns, just gonna call him productive.
What do you want?
This guy had a.
And he gets in. Touchdown, Tennessee. Derrick Henry, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Titans. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down. Tannehill going to turn and give this to Henry. He's going to be dropped following a pickup of seven, past the 30 to the 32. Tannehill on third down. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up. They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. We'll call that a 43-yard punt, two on the return, and it'll be Seahawk football first and 10. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. They're going to have to go at least 50, 60 yards here if they want to ensure that they don't have to punt the ball like they did last time.
Yeah, so what you're saying is we're not playing to just get out of the shadow of your own goal line, right? You're playing to make sure the punter doesn't see the field again. So he's not picking up a couple of first downs. You want to pick up five or six first downs and make sure you move the ball to their territory.
Give them 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give them a first down.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
Now a first down throw, Tannehill sliding out of the pocket. And that is incomplete.
As his old brain remembers, when I see five wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
On second down, it's Henry, and he'll get about six up to the 27-yard line. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him, so when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, it makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
Looking deep for Julio. He's caught on the sideline, but he's not going to have a first down. They say he was out of bounds. So a big call there. That brings up fourth. 46 on his first kick. This one in that neighborhood as well. It'll be a net of 40 yards there following a 43-yard punt, 3-yard return, and the offer. With a little over 2 minutes to play in the second quarter, the offense gets ready to take over. Escaping the pressure right, and caught by Henry. And he will lose yardage on the play, back at his own 19-yard line. He was unable to shake free there, and they'll cover him for a loss of a yard. We've hit the 2-minute mark of the second quarter, 14-7. A reminder coming up at halftime, we'll head to Orlando. Standing by there, Jonathan Coachman. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL in this second week of the regular season. And incomplete on the deep ball.
And I think they'd be well served to take that type of a physical approach against him the rest of the game. He's had his way so far. But on that last one, that worked quite well for the defense.
This complete to Jones. And he will have a Titans first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. A gain of 22. On first down, it's Tannehill. Flushed out right. Caught on the right side by Jones. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Of course, he was solid last week. AFC Offensive Player of the Week award. 2 touchdowns in that game.
Yeah, he's playing at a level right now where he's just breaking down defenses. Makes me remember when I was playing and my defensive back coach told me, listen, if you give up a touchdown pass, that's on me. I didn't coach you well enough. If you give up a second one, that's on you. And if there's a third one, I'm getting someone else in the game.
And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. Well, the incompletion, yes, but maybe here not the worst thing in the world?
No, not on first and 10. Actually gives them a chance to regroup, relax just a little bit. They huddle up, talk it over. Then they get a chance to continue their drive.
And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Jordan Brooks. Credit him with a sack as he buries him for a loss of 10.
Enough takes to start to have a good drive. Quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
Now they're looking at a third and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
And he can only manage to get this to the 45-yard line, well short of the first. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
And it's going to be batted. This offense ready to get back out there as they'll have the football to start the third quarter. Second half begins with a run by Henry. And some room to run now. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. 52 yards rushing for him now, and he's carried the ball just 5 times. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Play action, it's Tannehill. He's going deep for Brown. And this nearly an interception, but it's incomplete. Well, a turnover really would have helped him there, but not to be. Ball on the 42 as they come up second and 10. Henry running right. Uses the stiff arm. And he's going to get this inside the 30. 13 yards is the pickup for Tennessee and a first down. This is Henry. A solid stiff arm. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down. On that last run, he's now hit the 6,000-yard mark for rushing yards in his career.
And moves him squarely into the top 100 rushers of all time. In fact, he can boast that he's rushed for over 1,000 yards more than Gale Sayers did in his career. And Gale Sayers was a Hall of Famer in a short career.
And the Titans are going to have first and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points. He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a first down. They'll try to run this one in, and he will score. Touchdown, Titans. So now this offense will take over, and they will have the football at their own 20-yard line. Now Tannehill. Oh, into a sea of defenders and intercepted. Picked off by Jamal Adams. And he'll take this down inside the 15-yard line. So this is something we didn't see. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. Now a throw right side taken in here to start this drive. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. Good yardage after the catch. Is that play good for 30 and a first? From the gun, here's Tannehill on the move to his left. Looking in zone for Jones. Open man, Julio. Touchdown, Tennessee. Julio Jones. The Titans offense set to begin the drive. Their lead back down to one score after the touchdown a moment ago. First down's a must on this drive as they start out here first and 10. Here's Tannehill. Steps away to his left. Shreds him with a stiff arm. And he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. Good coverage downfield led to him taking off, picking up the first down on a 13-yard run. Here's Tannehill. Flush to his right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And he overshot him there. It's out of bounds, incomplete. He was trying to get it to A.J. Brown that time. And that'll bring up second down. Out of the gun, Tannehill out to his left. He dumps it off for Henry. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. That's a first down pickup for Tennessee on a gain of 10.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect them to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
On first and 10, Tannehill. And he'll get this underneath to Henry. And he is across midfield from 149 to the other 49, a gain of just two. That catch good for only a couple. From just shy of midfield, Tannehill dancing to his left. Looking downfield for Jones. And this is incomplete. Oh, he looked like he had a pretty good line on that one. That would have been a big play, but he could not pull it in. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Henry. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. That goes for a gain of 31. The offense has to love that because that was just a dump down, and then he turned something out of seemingly nothing.
And the best quarterbacks understand that dumping it down is often a good play, a better play than even what was drawn up.
Ronald Blair on the stop, able to stay in bounds, and the clock keeps rolling. This defense right now backed up in the red zone. Another touchdown, it's over. They've got to stand tall quickly.
Been in this spot before. Now there's a little bit of desperation creeping in, and all you're doing when you're talking to your defensive teammates is first guy there, hold him up. Second, third guy in, rake at the football. Get it out. We've got to create a turnover because one more score, and this game's over.
Throwing on third down, Tannehill. Eluding the pressure right. And this is caught. And that could seal it. It's a touchdown. So now we're in the final minute of the game in the fourth quarter as this offense gets ready to take over. They run with Henry on first down, but nothing much materializing as he'll get forward only for about a yard. I guess the simple question, why not just take a knee there?